Good morning and welcome to our Epiphany service. Epiphany is one of my favorite seasons, and this is one of my favorite services, so welcome. We are having a BAS service, so if you have your service books, it begins on page 185 or the bulletin that was hopefully emailed to you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Please join me in the comment. Let us pray. Eternal God, who by a star led wise men to the worship of your Son, guide by your light the nations of the earth, that the whole world may know your glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our first reading comes from the book of Isaiah. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will rise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your light, your eyes, and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your son shall come from far away, and your daughter shall be carried by their nurse's arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you. The wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, the young camels of Midian and Ephah. All those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our second reading comes from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. This is the reason that I, Paul, am a prisoner for Christ Jesus, for the sake of you Gentiles. For surely you have already heard of the commission of God's grace that was given me for you, and how the mystery was made known to me by revelation, as I wrote above in a few words, a reading of which will enable you to perceive my understanding of the mystery of Christ. In former generations, this mystery was not made known to humankind, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. That is, the Gentiles have become fellow heirs, members of the same body, and sharers of the promise of Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this gospel I have become a servant, according to the gift of God's grace that was given me by the working of God's power. Although I am the very least of all the saints, this grace was given to me to bring to the Gentiles the news of the boundless riches of Christ, and to make everyone see what is the plan of the mystery hidden for ages in God who created all things. So that through the church, the wisdom of God, in its rich variety, might now be made known to the rulers and authorities in the heavenly places. This was in accordance with the eternal promise that he has carried out in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have access to God, in boldness and confidence through faith in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, according to Matthew. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising, and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay homage to him.' When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road." The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus, soften our hearts, our minds, our ears, our mouths, our very souls, that we may know you and can draw closer to you. Amen. So, Epiphany, why is it my favorite season? Well, one thing is, I love to learn. And I love to see God in everyday things. See, I actually grew up with the word Epiphany being common language in my household. Someone would actually say, I just had an epiphany. I just understood something I hadn't known before. So when we lost that everyday word of epiphany, we actually gained another word. And so in the 80s and 90s and even into the 2000s, we'll say, I had an aha moment. An aha moment. And see, that's a moment where all of a sudden something we've been not quite understanding or not quite knowing how to do clicks. And all of a sudden it makes sense to us. So what's the beauty of Epiphany? It's a time when all of a sudden the Holy breaks into our world and makes sense to us. So the time of Epiphany is a time of journey. It's a time when wise men, and I always ponder this, how they were sitting up, they were close friends and not best of friends, because they'd worked together forever and searched the skies forever and gleaned wonders. And all of a sudden, they had a moment on the hill where they knew something. Something incredible had happened. And they were brave enough to turn to each other and say, see that star? That's something special. And we need to follow it. We need to follow it. And see, that's just where that story begins, because then they had to be brave enough to go home and tell their wives that they were going to follow that star. Now, that meant the wives had to gather up all the kids, all of the household items, all of the raft of animals, everything, because it didn't just mean that three men on camels went looking for this star. Everybody kind of went with them. That's the way it was in that time. The whole village went looking for Jesus. Now, did only the three men come in and see Mary and Joseph and Jesus? Yes, that would have been the way. But they wouldn't have traveled alone. They would have traveled in a caravan to find him. So there was a village that went. And anytime we have an aha moment, it's not just our moment, it's the village's moment. So this year we have had worldwide many aha moments. We have had to learn about an incredible disease that was, started out being like, well, it's kind of like the flu. People get it, some people will die, some people will stay. And then we learned about it. No, it wasn't like the flu. No, it was much more dangerous. Yes, many people will die. And how can we keep that from happening? And we had some aha moments where we learned to use masks, how to properly wash our hands, even though our doctors and moms and dads have been teaching us for years how to properly wash our hands. How important it was to not only take care of our own health, but also to include the entire village's health in that. And we also had to look for God's promises along the ways. Those moments when God broke into us and said, call your sister Sue, she's going through a rough time. Call your friend Harold, he's not doing so well. And we would pick up that phone and reach out and find out that yes, they did need to hear from us. Yes, they did dearly love us. But that we could be that encouraging word. We could be that hand and feet of God that reached into their world and said to them, of you I love, you are beloved of me. And we learn the importance of reaching out to others and also of reaching out to ourselves to say, yes, we matter. Yes, we need to care for each other. Yes, we need to make an intentional reaching out to the world. We need to just slow down, call calm our fears, because it has been a time of anxiety and fear. And know that God is with us. During my time of working with Epiphanies, I have learned that God speaks to me through daily little things. I'll be driving somewhere and all of a sudden I will hit every green light because I am on God's way. I'll drive into a parking lot, which I haven't done in a while because we're in lockdown, and there'll be a parking space right in front of where I need to go. One of my dearest friends, Nancy, says she likes going shopping with me because there's always parking spaces when she goes with me. And I just giggle because, of course, there are going to be parking spaces. I don't care if I have to walk a little ways or not. God will go before me. Do you know that God goes before you? Do you know deep in your heart that wherever you are, God is leading you? God is. God is part of your world. Sometimes we need to turn that voice up a little bit. We were just talking about the fact that sometimes my voice doesn't come over the recording very well because I'm soft-spoken. And I've learned that I have to turn up my volume a little bit so that others can hear me. I don't want to be anything but soft-spoken, that's who I am, but I can still project better if I turn my own volume up. So how do we turn God's volume up in our life? One way is through prayer. If we get up in the morning and one of the first things we do is say the Our Father and say to God, what do you want me to do this day? What can I do for you? Then we are opening our day and our path and our heart up to God. And then we faithfully go about our day. It doesn't mean that anything wondrous is going to happen. It doesn't mean that we're going to see a star and follow it. What it does mean is that we are faithfully going to walk out as children of God and love the world. And that is our job. That is our role in life. Everyone is called to use the gift of love. And then to use the other gifts that God has given you. So as you walk about this Epiphany season, find a new way to ask God into your heart and ask God to use you in this world, that you can be part of those aha moments, the moments where people think as you leave their conversation with them, be it on the phone or on Skype or FaceTime or whatever it is, however you're speaking with people, that they may think as you leave, thank God for that person. They have just been a truly gift to my life. For you are a gift to the people around you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. I invite you to open up your prayer books, if you have them, to the Nicene Creed. And it is on page 188, or it is in your service bulletin. Let us confess the faith of our baptism as we say, we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. For the prayers of the people this morning, we're using Prayers of Intercession for Common Worship by Susan Sayers. So this is an Anglican book from Great Britain. Jesus, the promised Messiah, is shown to the Gentile world. Let us pray to the God who loves us and knows the terrain we travel. We thank God for all those who brought the good news of Jesus to us and all who nourished our faith today. We pray that the whole people of God may work in unity and openness for the coming of God's kingdom. Living God, we offer you ourselves. We thank you, God, that salvation is for all people, and pray for a just and accepting world, where none is rejected, despised, or treated with contempt. Living God, we offer you ourselves. We thank God for the privilege of parenting and of living in communities. We pray that our homes and churches may be welcoming and generous-hearted. Living God, we offer you ourselves. We thank you, God, for all who care with such thoughtfulness and practical loving, for those who are vulnerable, and especially for the very young. We pray for healing and wholeness, peace of mind, protection, and hope. Living God, we offer you ourselves. We thank you, God, for all who have reached the end of their earthly journey in faith, that they may be welcomed into God's eternity. May we use the time left to us here as good stewards of God's gifts. Living God, we offer you ourselves. We thank you, God, for including us in the plan of salvation, and pray that we may be made worthy of our calling. Living God, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. And on page 191, dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. God welcomes sinners and invites them to this table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The grace and peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Amen.
give thanks, thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
Give our thanks and praise. It is indeed right that we should praise you, gracious God, for you created all things. You formed us in your own image. When we turned away from you in sin, you did not cease to care for us, but opened a path of salvation for all people. You made a covenant with your servants, Abraham and Sarah, and gave the promise of a blessing to all nations. Through Moses, you led your people from bondage into freedom. Through the prophets, you renewed the promise of salvation. Therefore, with them and with all your saints who have served you in every age, we give thanks and raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Holy God, source of life and goodness, all creation rightly gives you praise. In the fullness of time, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He healed the sick. He ate and drank with outcasts and sinners. He proclaimed the good news of your kingdom to the poor and those in need. In all things, he fulfilled your gracious will. On the night he freely gave himself to death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, we thank you, God. He broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, we thank you, God. He gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Gracious God, his perfect sacrifice destroys the power of sin and death. By raising him to life, you give us life forevermore. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. Recalling his death, proclaiming his resurrection, and looking for his coming again in glory, we offer you this bread and this cup. Send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts, that all who eat and drink at this table may be one body, one holy people, a living sacrifice in Jesus Christ our Lord. Through Christ, with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
Now, as our Father taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." "I am the bread of life," says the Lord. "Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. Whoever believes in me will never thirst."
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Happy are they who trust in him. Please join me in the prayer after communion. God of all the nations of the earth, guide us with your light. Help us to recognize Christ as he comes to us in this Eucharist and in our neighbors. May we welcome him with love, for he is Lord now and forever. Amen. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the Church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen. May God, who sent the Holy Spirit to rest upon the only begotten at his baptism in the Jordan River, pour out that Spirit on you, who have come to the waters of new birth. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you, your friends and family, and remain there always. Amen.
Amen.
A community reminder, Bishop Todd will not be with us next week. We will have a regular Epiphany service, but he will come and join us sometime later in the year when he can actually be with us because he would like to see us. This is one of his home churches, and we look forward to that visit. So go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.